Hey everyone, thanks for joining me. I'm going to show you some new features coming to Templater. These are all about controlling your layer's essential properties using the data connected to Templater. So this opens up a lot of opportunities for automatically reversioning MoGurt files right out of the box. So let's dive right in and take a look. All right, so I've got this project open. I've been working with it and I've set up some essential graphics properties in the essential graphics panel for this composition named main. And so what I want to do is I want to be able to drive essential graphics properties values with Templater. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to take this main composition in the project panel and I'm going to drag it into this new composition button to create a embedded layer of main in a new comp. So let's go like that. And here's main sitting as a singular layer inside of this main 2. I'm just gonna rename main 2 to something more intelligible and that makes more sense. So I'm gonna call this render and click OK. And so now we have the main composition as a layer inside of the render comp. And I'm gonna go ahead and rename this composition layer to something like assembly. Okay. And then I'm gonna go ahead and apply the Templater settings effect to that layer. All right, so now that layer is marked as dynamic according to Templater. But if I open up this Twirly, I now have a essential properties set of properties here on the layer. Now these properties are instances of these essential properties up here. Okay, so if I were to change something down here, like let's say font size, that does not change this value here. That's only local to this layer here, which is a pre-comp layer of the main composition. All right, so let's say we want to drive font size with the with Templater, or I want to drive any of these values with Templater. So what I'm going to do is make sure that this project is linked to a specific JSON file. And then what we're going to do is open up that JSON file that's right here. What's required to adjust essential graphics properties is you have to target the layer and use this at EGP postfix on the layer name as the key. And then the sub object here is a one-to-one mapping of all of the essential graphics properties that were created here for this particular composition. So here I've got four properties at the root, and then I have this labels property, which you can see here, this is a group, and I've added two properties here. So when we bring up the JSON, you can see these two correspond to here, okay? So this is how you target specific layers' essential properties. You create a key in your JSON with the layer name. You have the at EGP postfix for that. You make sure that the layer has the Templater settings effect applied to it, that it's renamed according to how you're identifying it in the JSON data. And then here, you have to make sure that you've got essential properties, obviously, on the layer that you want to reversion. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to kind of pull all the values from the master of this assembly layer, which is main. We're going to pull them down, and that kind of resets this instance of this layer to look exactly like this one. Okay, what we're going to do is just go here and hit reload, and that's going to basically pipe in all of these values here into these properties here. So we're going to hit reload. Okay, so basically what you've seen here now is that those values that were found here are now popped up in here. Okay, so what we're going to do is change those values up a little bit so you can see. So I'm going to kind of do that, but I'm going to make this guy a little bit narrower, something like that. And obviously we don't need that much here. Make this the project. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we are going to show you that as I change these here, this is going to change as well. So let's kind of go like that. And for the font color, for example, instead of null, let's go ahead and make it something like a blue. So we say red, green, blue at 255. And then the opacity, let's just make it even more faint. And then for the remove new lines, we'll leave that as true. And then labels American, that's fine. And then we'll just change this from North American English to English. Hit save. And then we're going to reload. And then all of this should change. And you can see the values have been updated here. Now, none of these have been touched. These are kind of like the master defaults or the master control. And they're created when the author or you move properties from these layers into here. So when you move it from one of these layers into the Essential Graphics panel, Templator doesn't actually address these. It doesn't manipulate these values. What it does is it manipulates all the values on an Essential Properties layer. I'm sorry, Essential Properties group that it's attached to a layer from this comp. Okay, so what's interesting though is that you can have many different data types. So the font size here kind of showed you that, but we can go and show you again here. Like if we go up here and we're going to make a key and we're going to say SRT font size and we'll say 75, hit save and then hit reload here. This should get bigger and we're going to actually change this back to null so that it goes back to the default. If Templator cannot find the value for a particular property, it will pull it from the master from whence it came. So we're going to reload and this should turn back to white. And then let's go ahead and just make this a little bit smaller on the font so we don't need to adjust it inside of there, because ultimately Templator is all about the data. And what we're gonna go ahead and do is, you know, I wanna show you the Boolean. So right now this SRT remove new lines, you'll see is either on or off here. And right now it was set to true, but if you can set this to false, and this will be set to off when we reload. There it is, it's set to off now. And if I set it back to true and hit reload, it's gonna set it back to true, okay? Now, the color is a little bit more nuanced. So with color, it's an array or it's a hex value. So you can see that the array works, but you could also do something like, let's say we wanted to change the BG color to red. You can use pound and then red, green, blue. So that would be FF0000 and that's gonna be pure red. So let's reload that. And then it comes in red like that. So for color, you can use hex values as strings, prefix with the pound sign, you can use arrays, you can use you know, numerical values, you can use floating point values for the sliders. For position, you can also send in an array as well, and that'll work. And so, yeah, those are all the data types that are supported that have nothing to do with media replacement. So what I'm going to show you next is how to deal with media replacement when you're using that with the Essential Graphics panel. Okay, so let's go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and open up a new file. And this one's going to be called example footage. And let's go ahead and just save that. Okay, so what we have here is just a really simple display composition. Some fancy smancy stuff going on in the back. And but we just have two video files here, this one and this one. And what I've done is I've dragged this one into here, and I've also dragged this one into here, into the Essential Graphics panel. And what happens is it allows you to do certain things now with replacing footage when you drag a footage layer into here. Now there are a lot of limitations, and you cannot expect to use that time sculpting will automatically work with this kind of stuff, because it's just not implemented for media replacement. So in that regard, I would recommend you use the data clays methodology for preparing a footage layer for dynamic sources. So however, you can still reversion media assets using Templator. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is let's load this and then let's see if we can find that data source and Here it is. So let's go ahead and open this guy up into Sublime. And here it is right here. And what we're going to do is, you can see that, you know, this is an array of jobs, right? And each job has a target of the assembly layer, which in the render here is assembly, and this is the display. I just renamed it assembly, and it has the templater settings effect on it. And, you know, these correspond to the keys here. Now you'll note for the video language and the video English that these are all file references, absolute file references, which are supported. But we also are supporting you can reference things, assets, by virtue of this footage library setting here. So it doesn't have to be a full path, it can be a relative path to wherever this footage asset is here. So as I move through the data, I actually have to advance this one instead of one, let's make it four and go forward. You can see here, I've got this one, and I'm on the Singaporean, or rather I'm in, the Tamil, that's this, and then the UK English, that's this one here. And so here, what I've done is I purposefully set this to the file, but then I added a .bak because I wanted to force Templater to not know where this file is or not be able to find it. And what it does is it is using its branded placeholder to change out this thing here. Now, what's really interesting is you can go into the essential graphics property here and say, you know what, for this particular one, instead of scale to fill, I'm going to do scale to fit. And then when we reload this, it's going to kind of be a little bit different. You can see here, it's kind of fitting in this. This is a landscape branded placeholder in a portrait composition. So this is what that looks like. So the author does have a decision to make as to how they're going to author the dynamics here. So we're going to do scale to fit. Okay, and then stretch is just, you know, sometimes that's cool and everything, but it's usually not what people want to do. And I think I did it on the wrong one. It would be this one right here, stretch. And let's see, you can see it kind of goes, you know, off proportion there. So, you know, you can use reversioning with footage assets, media replacement. And the nice thing is that you can also use HTTP URLs to reference your footage. They don't have to be local, and you know, that's fully supported in Templater. So all of the data types for the essential graphics are supported, and we're looking forward to seeing what y'all come up with. But this is the rundown, and please feel free to send in your questions. All right, thanks for your time.